Wait, so
we gave him four and he immediately solved them.
Why didn't we have, like, a reunion with Leonardo? He's, like, our best friend.
Because Leonardo needed to go to your mom's bedroom.
Sorry, I just wanted to say my penance to that. There we go. I really respect that, really respect that one pillar.
Nice.
I don't know. Maybe I'm being a little bit of a dick here.
Well, no, it makes sense.
Maybe I shouldn't say fuck off. Maybe that's kind of mean.
It is a little mean, sure, but I think it makes sense.
No, also, scratch what? That. This says it's incomplete. It's the codex pages. But... it looks like Ezio had them all when this memory occurred.
Great.
So you have to find the last one. How am I supposed to find them? Before you can go in there? Do the contextual camera.
It looks like Ezio has a map on it. He must have picked it up during one of the corrupted sequences. According to this, it'll show you the location of any missing codex pages.
So you have to find that codex page before you can do the next memory.
Well, that's okay. We'll go find it. I'm sorry. I shouldn't say fuck off when people, like, you know...
Yeah, well, that was a little mean, but I understand what your point was.
It makes me mad.
You were just saying, like, it's not a valid criticism. Stop criticizing people for something that's not really valid.
Well, it's just annoying. Like, usually, right. I don't care. Like, you want to, like, go in the comments and call me fat or annoying or whatever?
You're fat and annoying.
Fine. You know what? Oh, man, got him. Like, this is middle school. You fucking got me.
Right.
But if it's, like, some vague-ass detail that people easily could miss, and you're, like, coming in here, like, hurling insults and acting like we're absolute morons for not, like, playing the Ubisoft, what would you say, like, the nickeled and dimed Ubisoft DLC here?
Yeah.
It's like, really? I don't know.
Yeah, well, you should know. You should know that it's in there. That's on you.
It's just kind of annoying. I don't know. I shouldn't say fuck off, probably, but, like, I really wish that those people would either, like, lighten up or just go watch something else, like, that's not going to make them so mad. Because I get it. Like, you don't like when I make a small mistake, like, but that's going to happen here. I'm a human being, so I don't know what to tell, like, you.
And I think what it comes down to is, oh, there it is at the very top. You can get both of those. But I think what it comes down to also in terms of Ezio's character development is a very important overlooked detail that some people on the internet miss. It's our opinion. Like, whether you think he develops a lot in the game or not doesn't really change the fact if we think he develops or not. Right? Like, someone could play this game and be like, wow, what a great character development, but we could play the game and be like, he didn't really develop that much. It's just kind of all people's interpretation of the character and how they like him and get into him. Now, there are objective things you can look at, but for the most part, a lot of that stuff is really just opinion-based.
Right, the extent to which he developed. I think if you said, like, he didn't develop at all...
Well, yeah.
That would be, like, an objective statement, but right. I don't think we made that statement, did we?
No, I think we said, like, he didn't do a lot of development... Oh, get the feather.
In this game in Assassin's Creed 2, right. Assassins who got all of their development in one game.
We said the majority of them was in Brotherhood and Revelation for Ezio.
Didn't I also say, though, that slowing down that development was an interesting way to do it for once, and how, like, it allowed us to explore... I mean, maybe I didn't say this full thing, but I kind of was trying to imply that it also allowed us to explore more of an assassin's life and get, you know, like, revelations out of it, where everything ties together.
Hey, nice plug-in.
What?
To the last game, Revelation.
Oh.
Nice.
Yeah, that's what I was doing.
Yeah. But yeah, and I think the...
Maybe I didn't say it well enough. I don't know.
Maybe. I don't know. I mean,
I did just tell people to fuck off. I'm clearly literally Judas Iscariot and Satan mixed together.
You, like, are. You
raping
are.
Raping Euphoria or whatever. Or Euphora?
Yeah,
know.
Europe.
Europe.
The rape of Europe, also known as World War I and II.
Damn.
But yeah, no, it's... I think just in general, people need to, like, lighten up on the internet. Like, it's like, hey, I don't really like Ezio that much.
I would say it's all quarantine, but people were losers before quarantine, so it's not all quarantine.
Yeah, people are just losers.
But it's crazy to me, like, so you know how you and I like Connor?
Yeah.
Do you know what happens to me, just to me, when someone says they don't like Connor? Like, for example, I had a discussion, I think it was like a short one, with Cabbage Farmer.
Okay.
And I'm not shitting on him.
My cabbages!
I'm not shitting on him. He's in our comments, and, you know, he's someone who watches our videos a lot. He's a nice guy. There's times where he's pointed out things we've gotten wrong. He's never a dick about it.
Right. Yeah, he's cool.
So my point is, like, me and him were talking, and he likes Ezio more than I do. Although I love Revelations Ezio, and I like 2 and Brotherhood Ezio. But he still likes him more than me, right?
Yeah.
Do you know what happened to me when he said, like, well, I don't think Connor actually developed that much. Like, I don't really like him as much as you guys like him. I didn't, like, screech and drop dead, right? Like, oh no! I was just like, oh, well, why do you think that?
Yeah.
And we talked about it for like 3 comments.
Can you do that?
And then moved on.
Can you do that?
What?
Can you have conversations?
I mean,
and share other people and like learn about other people and their opinions?
It's very difficult. By the way, I didn't tell him to fuck off.
Huh. That's interesting. I've
Sorry,
never heard of that before.
I had my anger moment there earlier. That was a little too far. Look, once in a while, I get a little tired of being criticized.
Right.
Usually, not a big deal. Doesn't really matter. Once in a while, kind of obnoxious. But anyway, my point was just this. When he said he didn't like Connor that much, I was like, oh, well, why? And we talked about it a little bit. And I think part of it was that he... I don't know this. Maybe he... I don't think he said this, but I know a lot of people have said this. Like, people got used to Haytham and preferred Haytham, but he also talked about how Connor was very... Not the heck. Like, very serious and very to the point.
Yeah.
And how that characterization didn't connect as much with him, and he liked... He liked some of the levity brought by other assassins, even though they could also be serious, like Ezio. Mm-hmm. Which I understand that. Now, I've made a joking comment about how everyone wants everyone to be Ezio. I think that there are some people like that, who, you know, can't get past that characterization, which is why we got Arno, in my opinion, because he's very similar to Ezio's temperament.
Yeah.
And personality. You know, like, even down to his story, like, it's similar, like... dad killed or whatever, and then, you know, drafted into the assassins, all that type of stuff.
Yeah, he's like Walmart Ezio.
Right. And what I'm getting at here, though, is like neither of us left the conversation hating each other or super angry. We just talked about it for a minute.
Right.
And it was good. I still think he's a cool guy. That's it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that stuff can happen on the internet.
And if he made a video of his own talking about how he thought that Connor sucked. Okay. I mean, I probably wouldn't agree with it, but I'd hear him out.
Right.
I mean, you know, like, that's fine. I find Haytham a little boring, but he's still charming. You know? But, like, I wouldn't sit here and argue Haytham's objectively written badly, just that I didn't connect with that characterization, and that's okay. That's
right.
More on the realm of the opinion thing, like you said.
Yeah, I mean...
I think we should get these, by the way, because we're almost done with these. We're trying to get all the viewpoints and all of the glyphs before we're, you know, before we quit playing this game.
Yeah, all the glyphs.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, my opinion on Connor, where people are like, well, he's not funny, not charming, like Ezio. To me, it's like, does every character have to be like that? And I know, like, we've talked about this many times, but... the criticism of Connor being too serious and not connectable to me is kind of silly, because I'm kind of in the opposite boat, where it's like, if every assassin is just like Ezio, that gets very boring for me. Like, if I turn on a game and it's like, every time I turn on a game, he's like, hey, let me crack a joke! To me, it's like, okay.
Right. Well, I get that people had the opposite problem with Desmond.
Right.
Desmond's very serious and, you know, everything, and I get that, but, like, it's okay for some characters to be. Okay, I didn't mean to do that.
We just want to do it again.
I really wanted to see Florence again, please. Games are meant to be fun, but not everything needs to be lighthearted either, you know, you can...
Yeah.
You can do both. I mean, I don't know, but, like, at the end of the day, like, I don't hate people who dislike something I like, and I don't... constructive criticism is good. Mm-hmm. I need that, right? I'm not perfect, and I don't want, like, an army of yes-men who think I'm perfect, because I'm certainly not. But when it's just little stuff like that that I don't know what you're expecting, you know, like you expect just perfection and stuff, I don't get it, I guess.
Right.
I'm not Amazon, you know, or some massive conglomerate who can, like... I mean, I try and do all my research, but sometimes I miss something, or sometimes there's something like this where I'd argue it was forcibly cut out of the game for no reason. Like,
right.
And maybe it wasn't even made yet. Maybe they left it open and then added it in later, and like they had just left a door open for DLC.
Mm-hmm.
But either way, it feels like it was necessary story components that were not included in the base game inbox.
Right.
Which is a mistake, in my opinion. Like, if you look at other games... I know I'm looking at Bethesda, but like, look at Fallout. The DLC for those games, it adds on to the story. It's not like if you miss it, you don't get it, you know?
Right.
Like, if I play Fallout 3 and Fallout 4 and I play no DLC, I got the main story.
Yeah.
If I play Skyrim,
mm-hmm,
and I don't play Dragonborn, yes, I will miss out on some of the lore about the Dragonborn and other stuff. And if I don't play Dawnguard, yes, I'll miss out on lore about vampires. But guess what? I got the whole story of, like, the Return of the Dragons and stuff, without getting into spoilers here.
Right.
And that's the problem that I have with this, is that when you jam DLC randomly into the middle of the game, and then you are criticizing people for not having played that thing that was very clearly nickeled and dimed, almost, like in an EA fashion, to me that feels unfair.
Yeah, well, it is an unfair expectation. Because, I mean, like, me and you have played a lot of stuff. I personally never had access to this game ever in my entire life until I bought a PS4 and I got the Ezio collection.
Right, or them playing with me.
Right, so it's like, for me... Now, granted, that was the first time I ever played Assassin's Creed 2. At least the full game. But, so for me, it's like, well, how can you expect me to just randomly know about all that stuff when I never even played the game?
Right, and I know, so, a lot of people would say, like, well, then you shouldn't be making a video on it, but it's like, you did play through the game.
I did, yeah.
You didn't make the video on it without having played the game, it was just...
Right.
You didn't know that they had ripped that out before.
Yeah, I didn't know that.
And you can't be expected to be a, I don't know, expert on everything. Like, I get that that's kind of the expectation with YouTube and our stuff, is you know everything, but you don't.
Right.
I don't know everything, you know, and you don't know everything, and it's very easy to, in the comments after the fact, go Google something, or
right,
go look at 100 text documents and write your thesis on it, and like act super uptight and intelligent about it, and like, wow, I really got them. But at the end of the day, it's like, you're just being annoying.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do that, instead of like constructive criticism where you talk about it, like, hey, listen, like, here's the thing, here's how you do it. Hey, listen, I'm not sure if you played this or not, but they did add in, you know, these two DLCs, which probably, you know, you can even admit, probably should have been in the game, because they mm-hmm. were sequence 12 and 13, and there's a lot of development in those, so if you haven't played those, I'd check them out, because they actually address that criticism.
Right.
Cool.
There you go. Now we both know about it.
That's how you tell someone. You don't, like, act like they're a fucking idiot.
Right.
Like, it just is annoying, because it's like... If I come in here and act pretentious, which, to be fair, I kind of did with the fuck off comment. That's why I owned it and said sorry.
Yeah.
Because that's unnecessary, and I'm not cutting it out. Otherwise, I'd have to cut out a lot of references to it. But if I come in here and I'm super pretentious, you know, improving my point, or really disrespectful to you, like anyone watching or you, are you going to take it seriously or care what I have to say?
No, I'm going to be like, you're a dick.
Right, exactly. So, like, that's the thing, is, like, even if you're right and we're wrong about something, if you're a dick about it, we're not going to take you seriously. At most, it will annoy us. At least, I don't even see it, or I forget that you exist because I have other things going on in my life and I read positive comments and respond to people who are nice.
Right.
And then I just move on. Like, I've been insulted so many times on YouTube with actual insults, but I couldn't tell you what a lot of them are because I genuinely don't remember. Other than being called fat. That one's a pretty generic one. I get it. Working on losing weight. I agree with you. A little too chunky. Like, you're not the only one who thinks that.
Right.
But other than like that, it's like I don't remember a lot of that stuff, so what's the point? You're kind of like wasting your breath if you're going to be a dick about it. Other than just being a general nuisance, which I understand some people do want to be, so maybe even, you know, like saying anything about it gives them what they want. I have no idea.
Right.
I don't know, man. I don't get people. They're like, most of the people who watch our stuff are very nice. Almost everyone on the Let's Play channel, cool. I would argue, like, everyone is. I haven't seen anyone be mean on it.
Well, yeah, because most of the people that go to the Let's Play channel are people from the channel that genuinely enjoy watching these videos and are like, wow, these people are great.
Yeah.
I like just hanging out with them.
Right, that's supposed to be the point. We're just hanging out playing a game. We talk about stuff. If you disagree with us, cool, I'd love to hear why. Like, for example, like, I'm not sticking my neck out on this, but there was a guy, and I don't want to get him in trouble, who was talking about when we made a comment about Richard Spencer's ethnostates. We made, like, a joke about it. About how he said, like, well, it's interesting because some people think that those types of things should be available if someone wants them. Like, if someone wants to make a country and say, like, hey, I'm African. I only want Africans in my country.
Yeah.
That they should be able to do that without people being forced to live in those places. I didn't know anyone even, like, had literally proposed that really much. Like, I think I'd heard that once or twice, but I never really thought about it, because whenever I hear about that, I just think about people who are racist, who just, like, want to keep out people not like them, right?
Right.
But if you think about it, America, for example, wants to very much control who we let into the country, at least a lot of people do. And it's not out of racism, usually. It's out of just border control, right?
Right.
So, I mean, maybe there are examples of something like that where it's not a racist thing. I don't know. But my point is that this person brought that up. I hadn't thought about it. And I'm not saying, like, I'm convinced of it, because I still think ethnostates are a terrible idea, personally. I think that it just creates more tribalism.
Yeah, I mean, I'm back and forth on them, but...
But
anyways.
I do think, too, that, like, the people who think it would solve problems, all it would do is, like, make it so that people would find another thing to kill each other over.
Right.
Like, instead of, like, you're not black, or you're not white, it's you're not black enough, or you're not white enough.
Yeah,
or your nose is too small, or your neck is too tilted, or you have too little money. Like, people will find
Your dick is not 12 inches like mine.
People will find these divisions, by the way, mine's 13. No matter what, right? So
right.
To me, I mean, like, from that perspective of, like, well, we'd all get along better. It's like, would we?
No, because usually the issue has nothing to do with race or anything. It usually has to do with, like, money.
Yeah, that's so very true. Like, even like, racism in, like, you know, like, white-on-black racism, a lot of that's caused by area. Like, for example, the fact that... Black Americans were often pushed into poorer neighborhoods.
Right.
So they are victims of more crime, including, like, white-on-black crime, black-on-black crime, black-on-white crime for white people who got, like, kind of shifted in there, too, who maybe weren't the preferred white people to be around. I'm just saying, because there are those people, right?
Okay. Oh, jeez.
I missed. Oh, I didn't try to do that. What I'm saying by that is, like, a lot of that has to do with it was racism a long time ago, and then it ended up that those people were put in those areas, and because those areas are poor, people don't want to deal with them. And that's mean, but that's kind of how our government treats poor areas, if you haven't noticed. It's like, we're just going to stay clear of that.
Right.
It's not really worth our time. We'll let them sort themselves out. Like, that kind of thing. I mean, it's like Chicago. Nobody talks about how, like... I would argue the Chicago government has borderline, like, allowed communities of color to kill each other.
Oh, yeah, they do it all the time.
But they do it under the guise of, like, progressivism. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Of, like, freedom and progressivism. But it's, like... It's really because... Well... There is a racism there, like, on a systemic level with some of those governments where it's like, well, if I don't want black people here, what's easiest? Well, if I don't educate the young people in these poor communities, they're more likely to fall into gangs, which means they're more likely to kill each other and I don't have to do anything.
Yeah, and let's also plant Planned Parenthood in those communities.
So that they'll have less kids.
Yeah, there you go.
And that's what I'm saying is, like, I think that that's an issue with ethnostates, is you then also can end up with areas designated to different groups of people. We already see it with neighborhoods, where then that whole area is going to be treated poorly. You know what I mean? Now, maybe now it's the size of a country.
Right.
So what happens if, like, what happens if my ethnostate's bigger and I don't like the Chinese ethnostate nearby? Are we going to just, like, persecute them mercilessly? At least if people are mixed in society, the general population will accept each other and learn from each other more than if they are completely separate.
Yeah, I mean, it kind of depends, like... it depends. Like, you will have some people that will divide into certain groups. You know, like, well, I'm white, or I'm black, and you're not like me, so get away. But I agree with your point in that, for the most part, people kind of learn from other cultures and other people groups, and learn from other types of people and religions and backgrounds and everything that they can, generally speaking, learn how to get along more. Now, that is assuming you don't have, like, a media that's trying to, like, just forcibly jam race problems down people's throat every second of the day. So, I think if that wasn't a thing, I think more people would get along.
I agree. Also, is there a way to know where this is?
Where what is?
This.
A glyph?
Well, there was a glyph here. There. Torre del Dorologio. It's in Venice.
Are we in Venice right now?
Yeah. Oh. Wait, I think so. Aren't we? Venice. Yeah.
We're in Venice. Yeah, it might be that, maybe? Because it was... No, I don't know if it's that.
Well, could you maybe look it up on the phone and see, like, where Torre... I'll look at the thing, because, like, it says that it's here, and I just want to go get the glyphs before we're, you know?
Yeah, let me look on a Twitter map.
Something? Twitter map.
So it's, go back to the map.
Okay.
It's that building right there.
This one?
Yeah, supposedly it's, like, right there.
Okay. I feel like if they're going to show you which building it's on, it should then mark that building.
I agree.
Like, if you've seen it, right?
Yeah, I'm just happy we're in Venice.
Venice. There be Venice. Let there be cabbage.
Let there be cabbage.
No one cabbage farmer. Let there be cabbage. Oh.
Jeez.
Yeah, I don't know. What I guess my point with that whole thing, I know I got off track and I probably messed up by splitting it into two parts or some stupid thing I did. But my point with all of that was a point that I hadn't thought about. I still disagree with it.
Right.
But
they expanded your mind a little bit on the subject.
Well, but like the point was that there was a justification for it that wasn't racist.
Yeah.
Never thought about that. Still don't think it's a good idea.
Right.
But it's interesting to hear something I hadn't thought much about, right?
Yeah.
And that someone wasn't being a jerk about, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Do you require a medical assistance? Yeah, it's a pretty interesting thing to do online, is to share opinions and not get mad about it, but instead to try to challenge your own worldview on subjects.
I think that that's silly.
It's very silly. Like, I know everything. You don't. So whenever you share your opinions, mine are better.
I agree completely. Like, why should I listen to anyone who isn't me? Am I right?
Well, you shouldn't. I mean, you are the best. Why isn't this equipped?
I am the best, that's true. It's not equipped because I wanted to throw you for a loop.
Wow, you really got me. Woo-wee! All right.
Mr. Worldwide, in a canoe.
In a canoe. Isn't that like cultural appropriation?
What, calling those canoes?
Yeah. Because they're not canoes!
Weren't canoes developed by Native Americans?
I don't know the history of canoes.
I think they were. I say we give them the credit for it.
What if they were developed by...
They don't get credit for enough. They developed them. From here on out on this channel, I don't give a shit who made them. Canoes were made by Native Americans. They get the credit. They deserve it. That's the least we can do. Look at everything that's happened to them. they get canoes, okay? They get the canoes.
That is very progressive of you. I'm glad that you designate what other cultures get.
Yeah, they get the canoes. And frankly, I'm going to say that if you've ever used one, you're racist.
Wow, that, I'm glad I have not used one.
I think you have used canoes.
You racist. Let's deal with this gilf.
Guardians, unlock the file. Okay. I'm surprised we don't have, like, I'm surprised we don't have what's-his-face here, like, I was in bed with my cat, and it was like, oh no, and I was like, oh no, subject 16 or whatever. Epic. Nice. These ones are easy. I don't know why you were whining about it.
Because I don't like these at all. I get, like, confused.
I think you have to do that second one.
This one?
Yeah. Oh.
Huh.
Because you need to get that second to the outermost one to turn. Is there anything else that can turn it? Oh, there. Well, maybe you can turn it all the way around.
I'm going to get this one set for the middle piece.
Well, it was set. There we go.
There we go. Okay. Wait, now the middle is done, too. But wait, that second one is not.
Well, there's quite a few that highlight the second one. That one's the second one and the innermost. Wait, don't do that. Don't do that one. Go in one more. That one was the second one was, yeah. Try that. I can't tell how it goes.
Yeah. It also doesn't help that I don't like these.
I can do it.
If you want to do this, I do not like these. I don't find these fun.
I didn't know that that's what you were saying, was that you wanted me to do it.
I find these confusing, and I get really annoyed. Anytime I run into some struggles, I give up.
Well, I personally think that that's pretty cash money.
So you have to get that one, because that's the only one that does the outer rim. So no, that one's not done. You have to flip it, I think.
No, like, that one's done.
Not the outer rim?
No, that's the only one not done.
Yeah.
So I'm trying to see where it goes.
So...
There.
There. So now you can start flipping inside. I don't think that second one
wait
is.
Wait a minute, just wait.
There you go. Now can you do the third one? Somehow? Nice! Oh, dude!
The death of all tyrants will set the people free.
The death of all tyrants?
Epic. Wait a minute, what is this? Oh, no, wait, this is Walmart taking over!
Oh, no!
Not Target!
John Wilkes Booth?
Francis Duvier. Francisco Pizarro. Wait, John Wilkes Booth was an assassin?
I think he was a Templar.
No, now, hold on.
Mary the First? Huh. Cleopatra? Joseph Stalin, dude!
Joseph Stalin was an assassin.
Wait, why is Stalin, like, where, like, Uzbekistan is?
Just hanging out. Oh, okay. That was when he was on his lunch break.
Oh, okay. Well, they should make a game where Stalin is an assassin.
Epic.
That'd be awesome. That. Oh, dude. Oh. Oh. Okay, I thought that was the last one. That's just the last one in Venice.
I think
in Venice.
We're in Venom, Venice, Venom, 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 Venice, 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 Venom. All right, let's see if they're saying
We have Florence. Two we're missing in Florence.
So okay. Let's go to Florence. Do you want me to go there while you...
Well, are we doing these now, or are we doing the missions?
I think that we should do them now, because we're, like, at the end of the game.
Okay.
Like, I think we're in the last... Like, we're at the point of doing the last sequence.
Okay.
So I think that we should probably just finish them, don't
okay.
you?
Okay. Okay, yeah. All right. Let's do it.
Actually, you know what? I'm going to let you play now.
Why?
Because you haven't really played today. I don't know why I'm playing. You like Assassin's Creed.
I hate Assassin's Creed, actually.
I do, too, actually.
It is my least favorite game franchise of all time. Second to the Great Bratz Depression. Franchise, oh. also known as the Great Depression to the Bratz franchise.
It caused your Great Depression. Oh, mental illness joke. Isn't that funny? Mr. Woebine in the room. I'm inside of a room.
Okay, let's go to Florence.
Women, Venice, women, San Diego, women, women, women,
women,
Native American tribes, women,
women from Chinese. Native American tribes,
Chinese women, women,
also just Chinese people,
Japanese women.
I think Pitbull gets like the most amount of women of all time. Okay, where are these gills?
What if we made Pitbull... What if we made him talk about men in his next song, or we cancel him? Go.
Dang. Wow, I like it, yeah.
All right, it's just normal locations. Okay. It's not like it's some big secret. Oh, no, we have to find the San Lorenzo.
Okay, we're looking for San Lorenzo.
San Lorenzo.
And we're also looking for AC2. Mercato Vecchio.
Wait, what is San Lorenzo Bikini?
San Lorenzo bikinis.
Yeah, it came up.
Oh, it's just a picture of the church.
Also, it shows...
Also, what's the Mercato Vecchio?
Well, where'd you find your map of the one?
I searched for maps on Twitter, and I found a ton of them.
Wait, Basilica of San Lorenzo.
It just had, like, a general map I found on Google.
Oh. I mean...
Just look up, like, AC2 Florence GILF maps or something. Maybe do GLYPH maps, not GILF.
Okay.
You'd find some pretty gnarly stuff there.
Yeah. Good. Is this...
Which one says San...
Are we in Florence?
Yeah, we're in Florence. And we're looking for San Lorenzo. That's actually my rapper name, San Lorenzo.
It doesn't say... cathedral, well, roof of the northeast villa, like just a general small map? Distinctive house. Yeah. I mean, we can pull this
can
up.
Can we just, like, zoom in at all? Oh, that doesn't show anything.
Well, let's just try these. Let's just try these quick, because we're missing two. So, I did just want to find a map that showed where that...
Try on, like, Google's images, because the one I found had the picture and, like, the words with them, too. Yeah, like, what's that one? Is that...
There's no words, though. Oh, wait. San Lorenzo's that top north one.
Up in here?
Yeah, right. Up in here. Up in her.
Oh, no. The rape of Europe?
No. Anyway, I was saying, like, what if we make Pitbull and go, like, men, American men.
American men.
Native American men. Chinese men. Japanese men.
Woo!
I love men. And if he doesn't do it, we cancel him. That's what I was saying. And I thought it would be pretty epic.
That is pretty progressive, actually. I like it.
Hell yeah.
We should make a music video.
With Pitbull.
With Pitbull.
And we should be in bikinis.
And we should be in bikinis. And we should be like, rubbing stuff on his bald head. And just the entire music video is him being like, ah!
What if we're also
Mr.
like?
Worldwide.
What if we're also like?
Okay, where's this GILF?
It's worldwide.
And also, where's the glyph?
It's pull up your map real quick. You're right by it. It's left a little.
Okay.
And yeah, so it's like that way.
Like over here.
Yeah.
Is it like maybe on top?
Maybe. Okay. It looks like it's like right over where you are. Right now.
Like, right... Oh, I hear it. Oh, there it is. There's the GILF.
Epic. I need to know more about Subject 17 being with his cat or whatever.
It happened in 1908.
Oh, man.
Or was it 2000?
He's talking about the rape of Europe.
1708. I can't remember.
Was that it?
What happened?
It happened in 1908!
Nikola, okay. We know that what they have done to your lab, to your career, it may be too late to set things right, but you can help prevent something far worse. They have taken an object from the Tsar and are conducting experiments in Tunguska. Ooh, Tunguska.
Ooh.
To figure out how to use it. Before they do, we must take it from them or the world will be in danger. We do not ask you to risk your life. Just that when the time comes, you can use your electricity to destroy the object. Regardless of your decision, know that we admire your work greatly and will bear you no ill will. We respect your freedom above all else. Who is this from? Scroll down. Oh.
Oh, sorry.
I thought you could scroll down.
I tried, but didn't let me. What?
Maybe you have to, like, arrange the countries?
Oh, wait, maybe you're picking, like, where the ones that actually are the real country in that area. So, well, that's not Latvia's not there.
No.
Well, like, none of these are correct, then. What?
What the heck? What happened?
Did I guess I picked the right one.
Did Tesla bomb the Apple of Eden?
Hey, Tesla, we need you to use your electricity on the Apple of Eden. Oh, you mean drop little boy on the Apple of Eden?
No,
just the electric.
I'll do it. When we find the last Gilf,
The Last of Us, yeah.
I'm gonna look up like Nikola Tesla and just see like what they say that he did.
Okay.
So that we like know.
He destroyed a ton of Japanese people. That's what he did. Just to blow up the Apple of Eden.
No one Nikola Tesla. Oh, I heard you say Japanese. Like
he's just like to super, a pickle, so. He's just super racist. Where?
Up here. I don't know if that's wait, no.
No, we're looking for the Medirchi Vechuia or something. That one,
it's in the corner of that.
Oh, so it's right down here.
Yes.
Oh, nice, we're actually close to it.
Listen, Tesla, we really respect your work. We need you to shock the Apple of Eden. Nuke Japan?
No, just electrocute it.
No,
oh, never, it's already done.
I really don't like Toshiba.
Holy. The PS4 game.
No, not Ghost of Tsushima. Oh. Toshiba, the company that makes like electronics. He's like, hey, Samsung is for bitches. Buy a Tesla TV or whatever.
Oh, you like Toyota cars? I prefer Ford.
No one. You. Hey, we've got the new PS4 game, Ghosts of Mitsubishi. No, wrong thing here. No, that's not what it is.
Oh, they're the same thing. Okay, I thought this thing was here, this Gilf.
I can't wait to play Ghosts of Toyota later. Or Sekiro, I buy 3 cars. That's it, that's the name. Ooh, what's that?
It's a Gilf.
Sorry, I don't speak Japanese.
Oh, are you Tesla?
No, I'm Richtofen, don't you remember? Yeah. I'm thinking of that one. I'm sorry. I don't speak Japanese. Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, come on. Okay. All right. So that.
Oh, my gosh.